On this video, we're about to talk about the best brokers to start trading Forex with.
We come from poverty, man, we ain't have a thing.
We come from poverty, man, we ain't have a thing.
All right, y'all. Welcome back to the channel. It's your man, Ken. And as usual, we on a journey. So, getting into what to do and how to take control of your financial life. You can't continue doing what you've been doing. I know I can't. Listen, this Uber thing has been absolutely trash. But we working and we have a plan on how to level up. That plan includes, but is not limited to, figuring out what is going on with this Forex game. Now, when you're a beginner like me, I want to understand a lot, right? And I've been watching a lot of videos just to understand, okay, what is a T? Okay, you say you got to take profit when it go up and then it go down, and then there's pairs and it's foreign exchange currency that is attached to one another. So then the Australian dollar is connected to the American dollar, and then they go up, they go down, they go sideways. You got to try to predict how they go. It's wild, right? But it's a journey. The first thing that you have to figure out, though, is, okay, you've decided that this is interesting. You got to figure out how to trade it, because it's not like stocks. I can trade stocks on my Cash App, TD Ameritrade, Robinhood, right? All stocks. You trade stock, you buy it, sell it, do a put, little option, call, all the stuff. I understand the stock lingo. I understand this Forex lingo. So to trade Forex, you need a broker to get into the market and get busy. Great. It's not very straightforward. Like, you just go on it. It's a million different brokers that you can choose from. And there's a million different reasons why certain ones are better than other ones. So for starters, let's talk about the best American United States Forex brokers. So in doing my research, I came across a website called forexbrokers.com. And what they're doing is comparing the two best ones. The two best ones that we have available to us in America are forex.com and oenda.com. I think. Yeah, oenda.com. They compare those two, but there's also categories that people are getting into, because there's regulated Forex brokers, which means that they got all of the documentation and the regulation. And then from what I understand, they're a little more certified. You don't got to worry about some of the more riskier things. Like, sometimes you might not be able to cash out, or you may not be able to withdraw your funds, and all this other stuff that I don't necessarily understand. But I do understand that there's regulated ones that are more trusted. But the reason why people use unregulated, because there's regulated and unregulated. And unregulated has its own market too. And the primary difference between regulated and unregulated is this. I don't understand it all the way, so I'm going to explain what I understand to y'all. Y'all decipher all. You know what I'm saying? You can have more leverage on an unregulated account. On the regulated accounts, the leverage goes to 1 to 50. I don't know what that means yet, but the leverage goes from 1 to 50. Okay. In an unregulated account, I've seen a website where they have 1 to 1200. The way that people be looking to flip their account, right, go from 100 to $2 million real fast, is by increasing the leverage. Most of the traders, right, would experience that flip their account, rip, and they flip it and dip it and die it. They're taking the leverage and using 1 to 500 on average. That's making you risk more of your money with every trade. Now, from what I understand, this is also why people blow their account so quickly and, you know, give up so fast, because they don't have proper trade parameters, proper risk tolerance. I think that's what they call it. Because they want the money to grow today. right? They want to make $10,000 today. And some of them do, some of them don't, right? But this is what I figured. If you're starting out, this is a hell of a time to start, because a lot of the experienced traders are complaining about how you can't trade the unregulated accounts on MT4 and MT5. I don't even know the MetaTrader and all of that stuff. I don't necessarily understand all that yet. I ain't gonna hold y'all. But there's a lot of traders complaining that the Americans can't get access to as many unregulated brokers as they once did. In my opinion, that ain't your situation. So if you ask me, and you're a beginner like me, right, and you're just now looking into it, you trying to get started, stuff like that, in my mind, in my opinion, I ain't going, you know what I'm saying? In my mind, in my opinion, this is what you should do. Forex.com and Oanda, and create your demo account so you can figure out what's going on. It say that Forex.com has slightly lower fees. And the spread is slightly more in your favor. But Oanda, you don't have a minimum balance to start with. So you don't got to start with any minimum balance. You can start with $0, $14, $22, $100, so on and so forth. With Forex.com, you have to start with a minimum of $100. So that, and Forex.com has more pairs that you can trade than Oanda. But other than that, it's all the same stuff. In my mind, if you're a newbie like me, you should start with regulated brokers, because you need to know that the money that you put in is going to make you money. You don't want to put yourself in a situation where you trying to flip and dip and die your money, and then you make $10,000, but they don't give you no $10,000. They give you the two, they keep the eight, and then you going about your business. You don't want to put yourself in a situation like that. I don't know how exactly it worked, but my recommendation would be to go with the regulated boy. And from my experience, what I've found and the research I've done is those are the two best regulated brokers. Now, if you watching this and you the experience and you trying to see, okay, what this guy got to say? I'm a newbie. Y'all got it. Y'all the big dogs. Let me give you real quick a rundown of the best unregulated accounts or brokers that I found that y'all might be willing to use, because everybody with the all the unregulated brokers is getting kicked off MT4. So if you in that area, then let me give you the little rundown that I got. I ain't got no opinion about it. I'm gonna give you a quick little rundown. All right, so there's a company called Robo Forex in Belize. They gonna let you get the leverage up to 1 to 2,000. There's a Forex C in New Zealand up to 1 to 500. Nord FX is in St. Lucia, 1 to 1,000. Traders Way in Dominica, 1 to 1,000. Alpari in Moali, 1 to 3,000. And Fresh Forex with a 1 to 2,000 leverage ratio. Again, guys, I don't know nothing about that. I don't even know what it means, but I'm gonna give you the rundown because you came, you visited. I appreciate you. I want to give you some value. If you can extract some value, this is what I found. I don't know if it, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if it helps. I don't know if it don't. But this is what I found. So if you're like me and you trying to figure out your life and you trying to, okay, well, look, how you level, you know what I'm saying? You might be watching everybody's YouTube channel and then taking some of their opinions and making them your own. I don't know if that's your situation, but what I can say for me to you is that ain't the way. For me, it's a interesting pathway because I kind of got a cheat code. I have access to a group of professional traders, not just one guy I seen on YouTube or one guy's. No, it's a group that keeps all of the newbies, me and you, accountable. they send out trades that you could take. They're called tap to trade, which just means that you press approve on your MT4 and then you're entered into the trade that they've evaluated and decided that this is the safest, best setup. And the whole time you're able to learn. If that at all speaks to you, you don't want to continue buying course after course. You don't want to give this person your money and you want to join a team of traders that are actually making money, then please visit that link down there in the description and you can start your journey while I'm starting mine. And then we could politic with each other and see if we can make some money. Last but surely not least, guys, I'm going to be setting up a demo account with Forex.com. And the next video you guys see is what I'm able to do with that demo account, starting with $100 and my very, very limited knowledge. We'll see you guys on the next video.
We come from poverty, man. We ain't have a thing.
We come from poverty, man. We ain't have a thing.